for his take on another extraordinary week of pandemic politics and Dominic Perrottet's sprint to freedom. I want to bring in the voice of the people here on Credlin, 2GB radio host Luke Grant. G'day there, Luke.
Hello, Chris. Good to see you, mate.
Yeah, you don't need to be a fan of Dominic Perrottet's to acknowledge he's hit the ground running this week, speeding up the restoration of freedoms at 70 and 80% double dose, cancelling the daily COVID presses and dumping Gladys Berejiklian's hand-picked chief bureaucrat in favour of current Justice Secretary Michael Coutts-Trotter, who, for those who don't know, is the husband of Labor's Tanya Plibersek. How do you think he's going in just 3 days?
Well, I like it. It is only 3 days, but, you know, there's been a couple of things that have really impressed me. First off, at that media conference yesterday, and you and I spoke about this through the week, he owned what was going on and he made the very good point that this isn't just a health crisis. Again, this is something you mentioned earlier. This is a health and economic crisis. And he's taken the advice that's been given to him by Kerry Chant, who's been brilliant, I think, through much of this. And he said, OK, I'll take that on board. I'll take the other stuff on board. And guess what? We're in a position to do this. Now, that is what I call leadership. He's not beholden to the chief medical officer, chief health officer. He's prepared to take other considerations into account. And quite frankly, the extra freedoms that were given, Chris, were given to people who were vaccinated,
yep,
which is a point of getting vaccinated. Now, there's been this hue and cry about, oh, you know, now he's at odds with Kerry Chant and she didn't agree. And this is all in the word of, I think, one reporter. So there's no evidence of that at all. I think he got to his feet. He's probably caught a few people on the hop, and I reckon more strength to him. Good on him.